Hey everybody, this is David. This is going to be a short little video, but this is going to be a little recap of Cabo from my perspective at least. So I just wanted to talk about some of the stuff that we got to do and some of the experiences that we shared with each other and with the fans of the VU crew. A real quick recap of night one was the night with Guy Fieri. That was an insane night. I cannot believe that, because the night before that, Guy was there and we were just watching the house band. And then we got to hop up on stage with them, Dino and I, and we played a couple songs with them. I think we played Rock Candy and Rock and Roll. And Guy was loving it. He was like, "You guys rock." After we had decided to leave, somebody told us Chad was in there, Chad Kroger. And so we went back in, we got to meet those guys, and then Guy was like, "I'm coming back tomorrow night." So we were like, "Awesome." And he actually was there. So that was cool. He actually kept his word. We rocked the house. He introduced us. He got to come up on stage and start getting everybody to hand us money. He just hyped the entire crowd up. The energy from night one was off the hook. After we got off the stage night one, we went back and we had a little hangout with Guy and his friends and his people. And it was just a really, really good, genuine time. And it was something I'll probably never forget in my lifetime. Night two, we were a little exhausted because we don't know how to pace ourselves yet. Because every show we do, we want to give it 100%. But you can't do that when you're doing multiple nights in a row. You want to save your voice. You want to rest up your legs because we jump around and do all that cool stuff. And we rocked. We did what we wanted to do. We played the songs we wanted to play. And the crowd loved it just as the same as when Guy was there. Night three was personally one of my favorite nights of the whole trip. We were all like worried about the show, how our voices would handle. We were concerned about our voices mainly. That's what I'm trying to say. We got up on stage. And we had some technical issues. You know, you can't let those things kind of dictate the show. You got to push through them. We did. And I broke a string on night three, within the first four songs. And then Dino let me use his guitar for a song. And I was like, "Nick, do a long drum solo. I'm going to go upstairs and change this string. And I'm going to be back down here." So I went up and changed the string. And I came back down. And we rocked. It was one of the best shows we'd ever played. It was, you know, it was awesome. That was just something that was really, really incredible to see, that we just overcame the diversity of the night. You know, it was against us, and we said no, and we soared up into the stars, as we would say. That was one of my personal favorite nights. Now, night four was the night where the first three nights caught up to us. It was a rough night for vocals, I'll say that. The crowd loved it, and they were off the hook. We had our buddy Tim dress up as Santa Claus, and he came up and introduced us, and that was really fun. That was awesome. He got the crowd warmed up a little bit for us before we jumped on. One of Dino's uncle's buddies, I think that's the story. He let me use the drill for Pound Cake, and the crowd ate it up. We just jumped right into it. We did an entire set of Sammy Hagar songs just because it was his birthday, and we wanted to pay tribute to the guy who's inspired so many, as well as us. So we did an entire set of just Sammy Hagar songs. And then the last song of the night, we did one of our own songs. We did Mystery Girl, and everybody loved that one. That's a song that everybody loves. It's a song that we love to play too. But Dino and I had to leave. We scheduled our flight for a day earlier than Nick and Drew. Yeah, so they were there at the Wabo when Sammy was there. So they got to meet and hang out with Sammy and a little bit of hang out with Chad Kroger, just as we did. But, you know, it was awesome. I'm proud of those guys for getting to go up there and do it by themselves, you know. I feel like a parent. Overall, Cabo was a genuinely great experience for the band as well as for us personally, and I have a feeling we'll be back. That was just my quick little story recap of the entire Cabo experience. Thank you for sitting down and listening to me and my bedhead talk.